In Next.js, every page without exception is server-side rendered, but you have access to four different rendering methods that you have to understand in order to get the most out of Next. So let's go through them. The default one is static-side generation, where pages are built only once, at build time, and then cached to be served whenever requested. The second Next.js rendering method is called incremental static regeneration. It is just like static-side generation, except it now has a revalidation time, meaning your page will be rendered and cached at most once within a revalidation window. The third method is server-side rendering, where your page is rendered at request time and is never cached on the server. And finally, Next also allows for client-side re-rendering, meaning that whatever rendering method you use, you will always be able to re-render part of your page directly on the client side. And now that we know the theory, let's see some practical examples of those rendering methods. Next.js has an automatic file system routing, so any React component you default export under the pages directory will become a new page, with a path name equal to its file name. So by creating a React component under the pages directory, you just got yourself a statically generated page, which means you're using static side generation. Now, let's say you need to request some data to render this page properly. For this, just export the getStaticProps method from your page file. In that method, you can request your data and return it as props. You can then use those props directly from your page component. Note that this will not only reduce your user load times because the page doesn't have to be rendered after each request, but it will also reduce the stress on your database because you won't have to request it nearly as much. Now, let's say that the data you are requesting to build your page has to be updated once every hour. Well, just return a revalidation time of 3600 seconds, and now your page will be rendered at most once every hour. Good job, you are now using the second Next.js rendering method, incremental static regeneration. And we can go even further. If we make this page dynamic by giving it an ID, Next can't statically generate your page anymore because it doesn't know which IDs exist or not. To handle that, you have access to the getStaticPaths method, where you can request the IDs you need and return their paths. If you also return a fallback to false, it means only the paths you returned will be allowed, and the other paths leading to inexistent IDs will return an error 404. But you can also return a fallback to blocking, in which case any requested unknown path will be first server-side rendered and then cached for the revalidation time duration. Note that this is actually how I handle most of the pages on BuzzRank. I have way too many pages to render them all at build time, so I'm using incremental static regeneration, along with a fallback to blocking, in order to build pages only when they are requested, and then cache them until the revalidation time expires, meaning that the more people are on BuzzRank simultaneously, the faster the app becomes. Alright, now we know how to use static side generation and incremental static regeneration. So let's look at server-side rendering. Just remove the getStaticPaths method and replace the getStaticProps method with getServerSideProps. And that's it, you got yourself a server-side rendered page. Try to server-side render pages sparingly, as they don't scale as well and are slower than static pages. Finally, when it comes to the last Next.js rendering method, client-side re-rendering, you just need to know one thing. Next.js doesn't execute React useEffect hooks on the server side. So whatever you do in a useEffect hook, if it affects one of your page components, it will trigger a client-side re-rendering. Optionally, the team behind Next.js has created a React hook library called SWR. You can give it a look if you need to fetch data from the client side. On BuzzRank, I use client-side re-rendering to handle user authentication, because when serving pages, the server has no way to know if a user is authenticated or not. Alright, that's all you need to know about rendering methods in Next.js. I'm currently working on a tutorial series about how I built BuzzRank.io with Next.js and Firebase, so if that's of any interest to you, or if you liked the video, feel free to subscribe to the DevNextDoor YouTube channel. It would mean the world to me. See you soon!